somebody would lie on the internet.
Exactly. It was like, nah, he's not going to try out. He's just going to play like Kha'Zix. And oh, wait, isn't that like one of the best junglers right now?
To be fair, I actually would like to see him try hard on Ivan, because even when you're try-harding, it still looks funny, especially if you're playing the Candy King Ivan, just kind of walking through the jungle.
They're going to have fun.
I hope so.
Have to agree with Ivan, because there's been so many fun champions we haven't seen yet, but we'll see what the players have for us here in champs. Like Team Ice on the left, banning Syndra and LeBlanc, the first banner from Team Fire, so I like this. Ban away the really good champions so they can't get their hands on them.
That is a smart strategy. I think it's really good you pick up on that one. That's actually why we have bans in League of Legends, to get rid of strong champions so you don't have to face them. And Team Fire and Team Ice seem to agree.
Got to ban out the anti-fun champions
That's another one.
I want to see maybe some Talon. We're almost never going to see him in actual Summoner's Rift. So maybe if we see him when there's nothing but a little bit of fun on the line, maybe we'll get it.
If we talk a little bit about the teams now, we see these bans coming in here. Team Ice is pretty stacked in this.
Yeah.
Like BB, obviously strongest AD carry in the LMS. Mithy Jankos, very good combo from Europe, even have some synergy together, like just from in-house scrims and so on. And Wailers and Ziv are very, very good soul laners to have around you, especially for a jungler like Jankos who wants to play aggressive. So this Team Ice lineup is actually looking very, very good.
Only banned away Ryze and Lee Sin there, so Lee Sin away from Levi, but obviously a good champion instead. Put Trengo on the other sides. And this is where we're really going to find out what are the players thinking. The hovering Teemo, are they going to pick Teemo? Because this would be a great start to our last three games.
Would be a great start. You speak about like kind of how stacked they are. I mean, you can never overlook Smeb in the top lane on the other side. And
he makes the team stacked on his own, I guess.
Yeah, pretty much. And then, you know, you look at the bottom lane, and for historical players in their roles, Doublelift and Madlife are two of the biggest names globally in these positions. So maybe we'll have a little bit of fun down there in the bot lane as well.
Madlife always been a Doublelift mistress. You know, it was always everyone Doublelift together. But then whenever Madlife showed up, there were some issues in the relationship. Luckily, they might have figured out now. Or otherwise, Afrimo was sitting behind here watching this and being quite angry right now.
First pick by the Promethe. So it's not the Zara. I do like that we're moving away from that. And of course, Elysian taken away. We are going to have to see Levy go to something different. We'll see what Team Fire have in store for these first two picks, because this is a decent start from Team Ice. They're not, not 100% on fun yet, but this is definitely better than the Zara we might have expected.
It's a little outside of Mithy's wheelhouse. He's played it a couple of times when we've seen him on G2.
All right.
This is good. Yes, here we go.
Oh god, yeah, we get to new ones. I mean, we have seen Mithy play this in the past, you know, not lately. It hasn't really been that meta. It's more like a shout out to Krepo. He's off the caster disc, and instantly we get some Bard games here. And we get to cast it, and it might go support, but I wouldn't be surprised to see some flex picking here.
That's crazy.
Flex picking, like Wailers. He's an LPL mid laner. I'm sure he's practiced Bard
mid.
For sure, practiced Bard mid.
Well, Vayne, I assume for Doublelift and Riven, probably for Smeb, but you never know. We'll see what Team Ice have lined up on the other side. Don't pick Caitlyn, Team Ice, saw that hover very quickly. That's definitely in the anti-fun house.
Ooh.
Wouldn't mind a Jankos Fiddlesticks or a Nocturne. Ooh.
Now, this was one of the champions that Jankos was talking about that maybe wasn't quite so, you know, super, super serious, but Nocturne's been tearing up solo queue for a long time now. So, wonder whether Jankos, that's his fun pick.
I mean, yeah, the way, I guess, for Jankos really to have fun is not by randomly picking Teemo or something. It's like, pick a super strong jungler and then try and carry the hardest he possibly can, seeing as it was either Kha'Zix or the Nocturne. We did hear Mithy Blitzcrank, but with the bot being locked in, I would assume it goes to him.
Well, there could still be another Blitzcrank.
Exactly.
But we'll have to wait. It is Nocturne for Jankos, though, and I love this ISIM for Bebe. He's only allowed to play this if he picks his skin, but if he picks his skin, I'm okay with it.
That's fair.
Madlife taking his own Blitzcrank, so Mithy couldn't possibly steal the win, even if he didn't actually want
there's
to
do
it.
There's a Sion, there's a Blitzcrank!
All right.
Smeb won Sion for that top lane. Is this Optimus? Or is this Levy going... is it Levy going Sion in the jungle? Or is this Optimus going Riven in the mid lane? Like,
I'm gonna guess. Sion jungle, Riven top. We obviously get Vayne and Blitzcrank bot lane. I mean, come on. Signature picks for these guys. A lot of people actually think that Thresh was like the original Madlife signature pick because that was where they saw the highlights. Blitzcrank was actually the original pick for Madlife and the one where the Korean fans are going nuts whenever he locks that one in.
It's an old school champion for Doublelift as well, which is a huge throwback, but I do have Lux locked in here for Team Ice, which I do like, and Alawi, why not? Just to round things out.
I wonder now whether Elementalist Lux is enabled on this.
It is the patch.
You're on 623.
Yeah, it is exactly.
That'll be an interesting one.
if it is enabled or not. We haven't actually gotten to see this champion. We've seen it in solo queue every time because everyone wants to play this game. It's like every single game, it's there. And it can be very annoying playing against AP. I think so.
I guess that's Kog'Maw in the mid lane. We'll see if Levy and Smeb want to swap up their champions
or
not.
Is Levy playing Riven Jungle? Is he that guy from solo queue?
He could definitely be that guy.
He's at least in player, so it's not a huge stretch.
No, that's true.
He's like, come on, I can run Courage at the Colossus. I'm going to E-Flash W into the fight, get five people in the shield. That's everything I need.
You got to look at a man like Smeb, though. Like, people are having fun with their picks. He locks in a tank. I'm like, I know it's a tank made a top lane and you want to, I guess, follow that somewhat, but playing Sion in this?
I hope he's gone for Mecha Sion just for the train.
True.
At this point.
Yeah. I mean, okay, Sion is actually pretty fun to play, but against the Lowry in lane, that's not going to be too easy for good old Smeb.
I mean, it's maybe better than it for Riven. It's really rough for Riven.
Yeah, that's
too much stuff
true.
So maybe it was a flex. They were just going to swap if the matchup didn't work out. Not quite sure how it all shuffles out, but should be fun nonetheless.
It's going to be a good one. We're going to be able to answer all of those skin questions. That's about the most important questions left on everybody's mind. Gone are the point matters, as Team Ice have already taken the victory for All-Star.
But thankfully, you can still vote even if you want to. I know the points don't matter anymore, but your vote certainly still counts. So vote at LOL Esports with the hashtag FireWin or the hashtag IceWin. I guess that's now just for the game, which makes a little more sense given the Ice has technically won already. But at this stage, it is all about pride. Moral victories are very important. I will personally say more important than actual victory. Some may disagree. But for this game, that's what I'm running with.
No, I agree. No, I agree 100%. Because what we have seen so far is that when like one or two individual players have had like sick games where they just went like 10-0, 20-0, everyone talked about him. It was like, man, wow, that guy was so great in that game. It's going to be the same here, you know. Everyone wants to show up what they can do, especially on signature picks like Blitzcrank, like Bard. And I guess Wayless are back on his Lux. I'm sure he's been a main for him at some point. He's made like every champion in the game at some point.
I'm sure he has at least one or two professional games on the champion. He's actually not going to go for the new skin. So Stress, I know the skinergy was important to you. I'm sorry to let you down early.
That's all right. Thank goodness they added that extra particle on Steel Legion Lux. Otherwise, we'd be...
Yeah, because that was the one that was impossible to see before.
Yeah, if MadLife had been playing iBlitz, we would have had that whole shenanigans of things. But,
Gamble 0% number one does not pay off.
We got some cheese down the bottom lane. Smep is sneaking. Maybe he's very confused and going to the wrong lane.
Lane's off. Anyone? Oh no, I think a penguin spotted him. Oh. He's gonna have to go back home.
His world's level one strategy failing.
He saw that game with the Mickey and Splice played in the EULCS where they played Sion support and he was like, that's the game.
I am Sion support. Yeah, MadLife go top lane. Dobbith holding all to MadLife being, no, bot lane, stay bot lane. 2v2, mate. And they're going to get the 2v2, because there's no lane swaps in this game. May they rest in peace.
Well, it looks like MadLife and Dublin will help out at least with Riven's early jungle. So we're going to start here on the blue. Nocturne will do the same. I do expect Jankos to jungle maybe a touch faster than Levy in this game.
There you go. Courage of the Colossus.
Ooh.
And the Thunderlord's Nocturne. Just to get there, you ult in, queue them, you've already basically got it.
Storm Raiders Illaoi as well. Zip. Not exactly picking for laning phase with that one, but I can't blame him. He's going to probably win the lane anyway with Illaoi.
Well, not try can endorse maybe a skin choice, but we do have a 2v2 lane nonetheless. See how W from MadLife can navigate what is likely a tricky early laning phase, but it's all about the players here with Blitzcrank Vayne. That's all they'll really need.
Unfortunately, there's an Ezreal.
Yes,
that just going to sit behind his minions and Arcane Shift away, but W that time got caught by the binding.
And Midley 100% want to show some moves on the body. He hasn't gotten to play for such a long time. Now he gets to play it again. And it's against MadLife Doublelift. Like, that's a bot lane you really want to beat.
Especially if you make yourself look good doing it.
Yeah,
like,
exactly.
Catch him with the bot ults, the Qs, get all the combos off.
Smeb is catching every skill shot up in the top lane.
Here we go. Trying to...
He's got nothing leveled yet except for Q, so
Baby's coming up with him.
Ooh, hello. Here we go, portal in. Optimus gonna get exhausted. Now the damage will come down. Baby just needs a little bit more. Q's gonna miss. Oh, it's a tragedy.
He fired it left. The dodge was down. So much given, though, for that roam. I mean, basically the game lost right there.
I mean, there's two summoners gone from Optimus now. Game is practically over for him so far because he's on a champion that needs, like, 35-ish minutes to actually do anything. Because we have a lot of experience watching this kind of champion in Europe with Paravivo back in the day, these like snooze face games where we had to wait 40 minutes before anything happened. And if you camp them a little bit in the start, you know, he didn't really do that much. Great start here for Mithy and BB.
Doubling's looking good as well. Manlife can look for that next hook. BB, oh, oh, gets out of it.
The hard counter.
That's just not fun at all.
Yeah, it's not fun. See, this is what we're talking about with anti-fun champions in this.
But this is why you Madlife him later.
Yes.
And you actually predict the jump, and then you pull him in. That's going to be the trick. It's going to happen at least once this game, I promise everyone.
Certainly going to try for it as Smurf here. Oh. Ziv has come up as well. Ziv trying to dodge up. This is the first Q, trying to batter away at Smurf. Little vessel, but Ziv needs to get his way out of the way and maybe try and get something done here. But Red Buff River's chasing him down, and there's first blood to the jungler.
Levy with a good start. Been the best performing GBL member in this tournament for sure. Showing his Riven. Now, Jankos is behind enemy lines. He's not spotted. He's not spotting anyone.
Oh, now
either.
He is, because the pollen plant just came through.
Trying to gank mid against poor Optimus. Seems like everyone just want to camp him right now.
Well, it looks like Jankos not going to get anything off that. Nice little play there from Doublelift, actually. Getting a bit of vision, but Mithy again doing damage. Manlife knocks up Mithy, though. That's really the target they want to get if they can with a hook, but good damage traded back there. Smurf does double back to land. Ziv will do the same, and again, Smurf seems to be struggling. Oh, he's actually going all in for it. Smurf wants to get back in. Ziv
no!
got down with Ziv. Should be okay. Smurf's going to pin him to death instead.
One for one. Levy comes over the back of the wall. Couldn't quite get there in time, but there's a lot of focus up here on this two-tank top lane.
Two-tank top lane with Illaoi in there trying to go ham as much as possible. Big, big fan of watching like Ziv, Smurf top lane. I think these two are like some of the best top laners we actually have in the world. Getting to go ham against each other, obviously in more relaxed setting than normal. Jankos has still been farming and he's still around mid lane. He also has a Raptor biting him in the ass.
Oh no, Jankos! That's not a good look at all. He's biding his time.
Insane damage from those Raptors. Mithy, it's the European gang.
More tower dives, I do like it. Optimus could be in the spot of bother. Not going to get bound up there. The medical journey gets him out. Jankos with the easy dive and the exit as well. And poor Cockfor, he can't click the portal when he's dead. Feel bad.
That does feel bad. Like, Optimus is getting so many people in his lane. That's like the third attempt at mid lane. And we were looking at where Jankos was positioned. You're looking at where, how he was coming through. So that's probably going to happen again. As soon as he hits level 6, Paranoia is going to come through. And there's going to be no real opportunity for Optimus to get out with his flash still down.
All right, Madlife, where's the hooks?
Yeah,
I mean, Blitzcrank for about 6 minutes.
Everyone's relaxed for now.
Is that all he's got for you? You know, that's all you want to see is just one hook?
Oh, he had technically the one hook where BB jumped out of it, but I need to see some Madlife from Madlife.
I mean, that's what he's here for, certainly.
It's actually the only reason he's here.
Madlife
someone.
I mean, kind of say that, but he was certainly voted in for those early plays he's made all career long. So in some ways, that's what he is here for, but or at least what he's known for.
That would basically mean Insect would be at every single All-Star just to play Lee Sin.
He is technically, yes.
Smurf again. He's having trouble with Ghost Smurf.
Oh, Levy.
For a gank. Got level 6. Way. This could be in a bit of trouble. Gets knocked up. Stun's there as well, but can't quite combo the rest of it. Windslash will do some damage, but Wayless gets up pretty comfortably there. Does have to burn the Ghost, though. Oh, we're diving instead.
Madlife's here.
Yeah, I feel like now Team Fire is sitting around mid lane. It was otherwise Mithy and Jankos putting all the focus on Optimus. Rough start for him to this game, but now he's getting some help. Let's see, Jankos is level 6 on this Nocturne. He's sneaking around Optimus.
Straight to the mid lane. Oh, huge!
Poor Optimus sitting in that mid lane, playing against people like Wailers and Jankos, and then he's just getting ganked by the support as well.
Popped everything. This is, you know, a lot of people say, where did Cosmore go from mid lane? Yeah, he's kind of difficult to get through the laning phase.
Yeah, this is actually also like the last patch where you can like play AP because. It is getting slightly nerfed again. As soon as Riot were like, oh, AP is a thing? No. Let's remove it. Nerf it again. We don't want to see that.
Nobody wants to come back through it as Blue Buff will be donated over to Wayless back here in the bottom side. Baby and Mithy actually doing a decent job on CS. Not quite there as they've had left lane a few times to try and make something happen. Get the minion. All right, technically got something, so not too bad.
Now, if the minion flashed before...
Oh, hang on, guys.
Right? That would be the players.
Yeah, if Dominic was somehow magically able to flash.
He's found Levy all caught.
And a red buff.
Yeah.
I like the binding extension there, but that Levy should be able to get it. Does smite it down, so it's going to be a
Jankos got it. Jankos was the one that smited it.
In the end, Levy didn't want to sacrifice his life for a red buff. Can't really blame him too much. He has spammed.
Down there, baby. He's going to try and get his way out, but that's going to be a fail. Conveniently, we're in bottom lane because he is a Crepo.
Actually, the power of Bard. I'm just here to talk to
you.
Hang on, guys.
We don't want to listen, Crepo.
It's Bard Factor's time. Did you know you can actually get in between a tier 1 and 2 towers and go for a portal? Did you know that Kog'Maw is countered so hard by the Bard ultimate? Bard is honestly fantastic champion overall. Look at him. Mithy right there, the selection that is going to bring the victory.
Hang on, I need to write
Mithy,
down.
Mithy, do Krugs. We've do got Krugs. Everything.
Oh no, Wayless, that's a bad new time. Wayless gets
this
living.
This is now the Marshall.
Keep talking.
Keep talking. Just the ultimate on Kog'Maw, I think, is fantastic here. Beautiful pick in the composition. Works against Riven, works against Vayne, and honestly, that's all I want to say. So guys, have fun with the cast, but okay. The bar is right fantastic. There.
Thank you, Krugman, for the cameo. Is Mithy not going to get himself in safety? Oh, the condemn. That's a bad look, but now Jankos going to dive in onto double him. That'll be a kill for the back. Krepo, where'd you go?
Can we never invite Krepo back, like, ever? We missed, like, 2 kills. That's all he can talk about is Bard anyway, and Mithy's heavy.
Oh, it's a bang! Huge damage there as Mithy gonna go down by a flash from Jankos. Oh, it's a disaster.
Europe.
Is that down.
A
flash?
That was definitely. That was like Ewood Worlds, technically.
And,
except for Fair.
Always gotta keep that in mind. Yeah. They join Fnatic and Origin. And
it's a thing, you know, you can be super negative about Ewood Worlds, but too positive. We see Smeb is about to die to like 500 tentacles around him.
I feel like Ziv just wants to click on him and that might be enough for the kill. Good little pull there. That's going to batter him down once more. So Smeb is not feeling this right now.
It's actually annoying. You can't kill a guy by killing his like clone or his shadow.
Mm. Yeah.
Well, you can kill him if he walks to the wall and gets hit by that extra tentacle that spawns, but you can't actually kill him with the ability.
Since we're bringing other casters on, this is like the perfect top lane for Pulse. It's like robot trains and tentacles.
And it's double lift with a roam, does manage to get it. See if we can't sub Impulse for the top side there as well, but I like it. Man left and double lift, you know what? Bottom lane wasn't so fun, couldn't hook too many people. Let's go to some other lanes. And there's been an awful lot of roaming, maybe more than we're used to.
I mean, 10 minutes in, I think we've seen every single play in every single lane so far. Mithy's top lane as well now. Might have more action. He's level 6.
Here we go.
Has that ulti and a portal with Jankos.
This is the play.
What can they do together?
Well, right now they're just chilling. Jankos is going to go ahead and take the CS. It's all the ruse and Mithy going to leave. So sick gank there.
Yeah, that was pretty exciting. That was like watching EULCS. That's a joke. I love
immediately. The two EU players. Oh, look at this. Ninja and EM. Why'd you attack the Rift Herald? Gonna take this guy to grab instead. Maybe something he can't handle.
Look, this can't be like watching the EULCS. Somebody has to win.
No!
They've been revealed by Shroom and Ziv.
He wants to win.
Gets himself knocked back there. Manlove gonna get grabbed up, but here's the choo-choo train, baby. Flushes out of that one, but Levy get a combo him up. There's another kill for the Riven. 4-0-2 again.
Man, Levy is on every single game mode. He's just on fire.
He must know how to kill steal like really well, because his KDA is excellent.
Hey, you do not pick Riven if you don't know how to kill steal. That's like one of the main rules. It's in the tooltip again when you pick Riven. Are you sure? Can you kill steal? Yes, boom. Riven there. What is actually better, Kilton? Any other champion? Who has an execute?
Lee Sin?
Yeah,
Darius? Darius is pretty good.
Darius is actually really good. He was better before he changed it.
Unfortunate. Oh, Smeb landing it up. Smeb, he's comboed in. Another dive in from the Riven, and that's going to be another kill. 5-0-2. Now unstoppable. Everyone's trying to have fun, and Levy's like, no, I'm just going to kill
everyone. Riven's like, yeah, no fun. Just Riven, I'm going to kill everyone. And it's working.
Yeah, he's trying to make sure he's, you know, making himself look good. He looked good all the way through AWCA, so trying to just back-to-back put as good a performance. We were talking about that before this game, actually, where we were like, will people try hard? Will people, you know? I mean, he's up against some of Europe and the world's best, so.
Yeah, I mean, you can never blame someone, obviously, for going in and showing some skill. And that is the fun part of playing Riven. Like, no one wants to sit and troll around. And Team Fire, looking pretty good. 5k goal lead as well. And Mithy is once again trying to find a kill.
See what he can get here, because he's got the ulti ready, but I don't think we've seen him use it just yet. Gonna clear out some vision instead, and that double lift in Manlife are playing a little too far back, and the top laner in jungle. are back to try and make something happen here. In fact, Mithy might just face check a Riven. He does go over. Oh, that's a surprise. Mithy going to get the exhaust down, but Maldives coming in for a bit of extra defense. Portal's going through. He's going to ride it all the way. Wailer's trying to get a shield through, but the rest of the team's coming in as well. Optimus now looking for a couple snipes. There's Yankos straight into the middle, pulled back by Madlife, and that's an easy kill for the Cogmore.
Oh, Wayless was trying to get the ulti to line up and kill somebody, but everybody was full health because there was no damage done before. And Yankos, after, you know, this Nocturne pick, it's not really working out, DeVizio.
No, he's been looking for some ganks mid lane. Got the kills earlier. Here's Smep going again.
Uchu, who's he got this time? Baby! Oh, no, he's not going to get nailed as Ziv instead. We'll get comboed up. Madlife with the hook. Oh, he barely misses it, but Doubler still gets the kill.
Smep's been on fire as well. Gotta give him that one. He's been roaming a lot on this one. It's not over yet. Levy is around.
Not level 11, but they're still gonna hurt. Mithy flashed on Wind Splash down. That's gonna be a kill now. Dominating.
Catches him right before he gets in, and that was the play pastry. Flash in with the courage.
Oh, Optimus is here too. Oh, never mind.
He was there. Fortunately, Yanko's Wailers gang up on him. Managed to combo him down, but another turret's gonna go to fire. That's 2-0. Both side lane turrets now fallen.
This game so far is all about the side lanes for Team Fire. Wherever they send Smeb and Levy, they seem to pick up a lot of kills. Sadly for Optimus, he tried to join too late and actually ended up dying a third time. Everyone else is doing great on Team Fire, where Team Ice need to see people step up a little bit. Especially Ziv died 5 times already on the lava.
Well, part of it's because plays like this, Smeb through the top lane, gets the curve just right.
Yeah, honestly, kind of unfair. BB doesn't take the hit from the Zion and then just jump out after anyway, because he's not going to get, like, bursted down. Ignores it, jumps past it, and then, boom, Ziv gets hit instead, and he ends up actually dying for it. So to be fair, he is getting stalled out a little bit by some of his teammates.
Unfortunate look there, but Optimus actually okay after the initial early pressure. Does have a couple deaths, but he's kind of starting to build up towards what looks like a Ludens first, and he's decent on CS as well. Smeb in the meantime, still up here in the top lane, getting very tankly very quickly. He's going to try and do battle, but it's just a 1v1 for now, and looks like, very briefly, people will return to their lane assignments.
For a moment.
Yes, I stress for a moment.
And I see 4 members mid lane, but apart from that, Mithy has been very active on the map. Not been able to, sadly, land any sick ultis so far. And actually, same for Madlife, we haven't really seen him land any crazy hooks. It's not really been the battle of the supports just yet.
Well, like this little roam there is at least opportunity. This is a real tricky thing to face check into. No wards here either, but that will reveal them. Mystic Shot nails Madlife right in the dome. Instead, we might just transition over to an objective. That's a fail.
Well, you got it.
There we go, Blast Point. Saves the day.
That's why we put it in the game.
Yeah, yeah. For Rubens like me that can't make no one.
Oh, Dragon, of course. Mountain Break and Fire. He's got everything going for him.
Oh, Optimus, not again.
Oh, Optimus! Hi. Every time.
Oh, Smith, though! Revenge! Oh, gonna get knocked out of the bouncy castles there, and Madlife secures his first kill for the game.
Oh, they just cannot keep Optimus alive.
I guess he's baiting technically.
It's worth it.
It's worth it.
Totally
yeah.
Worth it.
Mithy's around his mid tower. So is Madlife, though.
Oh, Mithy! Gets himself hawked by the god himself. And Smeb's on a killing spree.
Mithy should have ulted the tower, kept it alive. Ah.
Snowballing out of control. Mithy could actually have ulted up in the air and then he was stunned on the way to the Blitzcrank and he wouldn't have gone all the way.
That would have been next level.
That would have been next
get
level.
Hooked, and then this is the path.
Well, Smeb's in a 1v3, but I don't think he took too much damage before. Oh, another Madlife, baby! He's gonna get destroyed. Maybe now Godlike with 7 kills and counting, and now Ziv, he'll be chased down as well. Stunned in there from the Riven W, and that should be clean up. Smeb getting his 4th kill now.
Yeah, once again, the top half of Fire here is just getting everything. 7 kills on Levy, 4 on Smeb, 9 assists.
Ooh.
Oh, now Nocturne having to flash as well.
Look at those Nocturne mechanics.
Impressive, he pressed him.
Oh, Madlife!
Oh, he wanted the plan.
He's through. It's gonna be okay. Rift Arrow now, the next objective for Fire. And looking good. Up a huge amount of gold, have 3 turrets already gone, and now Rift Arrow probably over to this jungler.
Yeah, and you know a team is snowballing when they can actually take a Rift Arrow, because it happens so rarely. But when you're really far ahead, you are allowed to take this objective. Levy gets it, he deserves it so far. Definitely the MVP.
Well, only man we haven't seen too many plays out of yet is Doublelift, so can his Vayne Going very fancy. He's going to look for a 1v1. It should be relatively straightforward. He's two levels up as well. Baby just has no chance. Heals in. There's the tumble. Flashing for the autos. And Mythy, they're going to try and make the difference. The double lift does get the stun. He will be stunned back, though. And now Wailers looking to snipe him down. Double lift. Do you have this 1v2 when you're going to dodge the first Q? But the autos are there. Heals maybe going to keep him alive. But that ulti does hit him. And this should steal it. Wailers puts the E on and see a double lift.
He thought he had the 1v2. He thought he could still do it if it was just Mythy. Wailers ruins a good 1v1 that we had there. Bebe already getting taken out.
He's gonna get another 1v1 top. But off on a blast cone from Levy, but doesn't matter. He's on his way.
Not sure Ziv can live through this one. They're gonna try and fight, but that's a lot of damage. Ziv is already dead, flashes and still gets ordered.
Yeah, sadly for Ziv, he's too far behind. Tried to dodge the potential stun from a Riven with his ulti, but didn't happen. Wailers.
Another great ult there. Wailers actually forced a flash out of that one. Noble get banned on Natara, but it's not quite enough there as Yankos are going to dive in onto Optimus, but might get sniped now. Should be okay.
Classic move, you know, in this game here. Team Fire tries to do something, and the first thing Team Ice responds with is dive on Optimus. Literally just trying to kill him. Yeah. This time he stays alive, though. Both summons have to be used. Rest of Team Fire is winning everywhere else on the map.
Okay, and this is what you do. Once you have got insanely fed on this Riven, you just split push. Doesn't matter that you're the jungler. Go the other side of the map to your team.
I mean, you are a Riven player, yes. So that is really a good thing to do. Same with the Shakos or Trinity.
Oh, no. Should be able to make this hop. No, actually, he's got support Madlife, and Optimus is going to look to clean it up. Mythy goes to his own.
Oh!
By Madlife! Absolutely insane.
Oh, good old Madlife.
Never changed. After all these years, his splits are still pretty good. Double lift trying to find his way out of this one. No, he goes in instead. Looks for Yankos to dodge a couple of skill shots, but still trying to getting aggressed and will wrap all the way around to his team toward the enemy tier 2 and Dynalox. Well done, mate.
I do like how we're seeing every single player try and challenge the other player just mechanically. Be like, can I outplay you? Can I outplay maybe the second guy as well? Everyone just trying to show what they can actually do, and that's exactly what you should do in this game mode here.
How long until Smeb TP's into the boss? Like, oh, he's got
his oh, Baby again! Oh, he's gonna get nailed, and that's no good! See ya, Sunshine! Baby goes down to Optimus!
I was gonna say, he could TP just in on Ziv, maybe try and just take the 1v1, but takes out the easy, squishy target, and I guess we get to have a look at that kind of mad life again. It wasn't really a prediction, I guess.
He knew Mythy had to portal, and then it's very easy to hook a guy who can't really juke because he's in the portal. And he just pulls him back out, takes the free kill really for his team.
Oh.
And now,
Mythy
just died for the first time.
That's good gold, actually. Wailers picking up the shutdown. His nice double is going to pop the Scryer's Bloom. Look to chase Yankos Blast Hunt, going to get him to safety, and Wailers is going to kite it out. Can't kind of get anything done here, but looks like they'll just give it up. Drake up in a minute, so no need for that objective just yet. Smeb and Madlife just hanging out. I think Smeb is doing the right thing here on the side. He's pretty tanky, he's gotten a lot of kills early. Madlife's face checking a brush, and that's not a good look. He'll flash out to safety for now, and Smeb, he's got some backup, so that's Team Ice through the journey and out.
Yeah, he's got a Smeb right behind him at that point. It's okay. I mean, Madlife and Smeb probably can take on most people on this map. Levy. He died. That's the beginning of the next phase of the Riven in solo queue coming into the jungle. It's the first death is a big
the
death.
The power goes to your head.
Yeah.
It all goes down here.
It was just a fluke. They killed me once. Don't worry.
So you're telling me that's the way in for Ice. I got it.
Yeah, exactly. That's right. It.
Straight through that one Riven death. It's totally fine from here.
Let's see who can carry the hardest. Levy, 815 on Riven, or Wailers. On the lock, 6-2-1. Wailers has actually been the best LPL player in this tournament.
I mean,
yeah, it doesn't Uzi say that up. Much, but he has been the best LPL player. I guess Uzi.
I was gonna say Uzi
1v1. Okay, fine. In the 5-on-5s, like when it was regional clashes, I think Wailers has the best.
So he's been the second best.
Well, I guess overall, then yes, fine. Who's just been the best?
I mean, I agree with you. Wailers for someone that, you know, didn't get.
There you go. You agreed. You're down here with me now.
You know,
we're in this together.
Definitely been a bit of a struggle. He's had a good performance here at all. So he's always been a strong, proficient player. And it's nice to see a little bit of that. So I don't know. I guess we'll see. Lux versus Riven, what's going to happen. I do like what Levy did with the blast cones there. But now he's getting chased out of his jungle. Yankos stealing some of it away, I believe. But he doesn't really mind too much. He's awfully fed still as Smeb is trying to line up another ulti. I love again that Smeb's just moving between these lanes, trying to pick off the next person he can find. win that choo-choo train. Mythy, see the big ulti yet? That one's not it either.
Haven't seen it yet, no.
That's very true.
There's still nothing.
Next one though. It is a good choice to try and aim for Optimus in the mid lane. He does have the swiftness boost. Try and get out faster of that potential. Bard ulti.
It's Double F's time to shine though. Two items.
And here's Smash!
Hitting the charge, they portal out of the way, but that could be a big knock on Jankos though. Spell shields it, that's a bit uneventful. But the tower they will get instead. So Siege Mode enabled for Smep, that's a tower for fire.
That's a pretty good spell shield that just shields like a train that's coming at a million miles an hour.
Oh, he's in. He wants someone. Oh, he's found Optimus. Of course he has. That's going to be the kill, but I think Jankos is going to go down. That'll be a kill for Double if huge damage on the other end. Now Ice not too short, they can do Double Lift flashes in! Good kill onto Mythy, and they've got Dip pull back as well. That should be another as Double Lift gets itself a triple.
They're still in front of him!
I told you guys! Whalers, man! What
the
a beast!
Second best LPL player at all.
Yeah,
star.
Fine, we agreed that's on it. Second, that's it. Fine. Whalers, what a beast, man! 8-2 now on this one. He took down Levy once more. Smeb is the only man in the mid lane. He's walking away now. Still a long way, you know, back in this game for Team Ice, seeing as they're still 6k gold down. Baron would be a good start.
He pings onto the Baron. That does seem like a decent next hit.
All right, let's see. So Edge of the Night was popped by Jankos. Jumps in. Of course he's killing Optimus, poor guy. Goes down, sacrifices his life, and everything looks terrible for Team Ice. Until
great for Double Lift. He's already licking his lips like there's a triple kill here. Two people around him.
The Penta.
Double Lift tumbled into it as well when it hit him after it actually connected to Levy first.
That was satisfying.
Hey, you got second best kill.
Well, it's certainly looking good as far as his scoreline goes. We'll see if he can keep it up. There are plenty of decent targets that he can snipe away. So if this game does get going to see significantly later. That could be it, but you can see, did most damage in the last team fight.
Mythy had a great team.
I mean, that's all you want is the support. You don't want to deal any damage. Technically as well, you can actually have a good fight as Bard if you like land the ulti from max range and then have a good portal, give someone health pack, and then you actually didn't deal
any
damage.
That's actually true.
Doesn't the ulti deal one damage? But it did some. Where's Krapa?
Get him back in here! All right,
Div and Smeb having a duel for now, but Smeb is got a lot more health, which is going to make this a little unfair. Flashes in, looks for the kill. Ziv just trying to run his way out, but Smeb is not stopping. Little Q there for the slow, but Ziv needs to keep running. Is he going to dive? He will, but Whalers could deter him. Smeb's like, I'll fight anyone else, but I ain't fighting that guy.
Just wait and see whether Smeb kicks a minion just to try and take him out, but hasn't quite got the range. Needs to go back, practice, maybe some more Muay Thai.
Yes,
get that him would in be there. Good for extra kicking power.
They were pretty good in the end.
Well, apparently all you got to do is imagine it's Double Lift.
Yeah,
the power just goes over 9,000 at that point. But that was a pretty sweet video.
Knowing this, Double Lift just picked up a Hex Drinker, does not want to get himself punched in the head. Uzi, thankfully not on the other team. That should be okay.
I want to see more snipe from Whalers on this Lux here. Last five was perfect. He's had a few good ones, a few would have missed left and right. But also, I think Double Lift can be the man in the late game team fights to kind of carry the whole thing. You said it yourself with the Hexdringer. It's ready.
Oh no, don't get baited. Oh, it's okay. They actually moved.
What a one over the wall.
The area. All right. Mad Lad couldn't quite read them through the fog.
It's okay. This is what all the Lux supports are saying. You just use Lux abilities to get the vision.
You don't need Sidestone.
You don't need anything. Full AP. This is basically Whalers playing support from mid lane. It's okay.
Yeah, I don't feel like. Okay, Smeb is now taking some damage. Finally.
I mean, for a long time, almost no one was winning that. And I think that's kind of the end result. But Smeb gave it a good go. Smeb just gonna take the minion wave instead. Welcome to top lane, everyone.
Might still get a big fight up here in the mid lane with 4v4.
No one is coming.
No, we get the tank fight.
Again. There's the sniper. There's the extra kill for Jankos. I 5v3 potential opportunity.
Oh, let's see if they can start Baron. If Ziv goes back to base, he has TP ready. He's recalling. Ice is running back to the mid lane though. And now they're all recalling. That is not how you do Baron. Maybe it's a new meta, new patch, I'm not sure. That was a pretty free objective. But anyway, I don't blame them. We want more team fights.
Well, I mean, again, we're kind of used to watching like the old Fnatic style or, you know, some of the other European teams that just run at it at 21 minutes and just go, oh, we'll just take it. Nobody's dead. So when people die, they just kind of think, I guess we should stop.
What do we do now?
Yeah.
Oh,
don't spend all that money.
Interesting to see. I guess Waylitz is the only LPL player on the team. They're infamous for rushing at the Baron whenever possible, so looks like the rest of Team Ice was able to contain that potential urge.
EU and LPL special is actually the early Baron. 100%.
You should watch EU Challenger. Nobody gets Baron for like 40 minutes.
Oh.
And then we just sit there.
Gentleman's agreement? Like,
yep.
No one.
Exactly. Just.
It's too good. Don't take it. I don't know how to beat it yet. I'll get there, it's okay. Throt Portal was the way from Smeb, but taken down there for Zib. Double of getting stronger. Infinity Edge, Shiv, and of course that Hex Drink are now done. So if we're looking for that big late game double of situation, we're kind of there now, but maybe not doing too bad either.
No, no. I mean, okay, 0-5, I mean, guess.
That's not ideal.
You know, yeah, I think that's like, maybe not the greatest, but Jakos on the other hand, had a bit of a tricky start. He's been picking up some kills now, has some good items, going for even more damage with the Duskblade coming in later. Trying to see if he can one-shot like double if the Optimus in the late game. See if he can carry some of those fights.
It's gonna be Optimus.
It's probably gonna be Optimus. It's probably gonna be Optimus.
He's got an Aurelius, he's got a Seraphs. Might have some tankiness in there, but I feel like you know, Jankos and Waylitz can team up if they can dive on one or two carries, preferably two, delete them immediately.
That would be great.
That's definitely a winning team fight for Ice.
You know Waylitz is gonna follow up with some snipe somewhere and see if he can take someone down, so.
I'm waiting for the miscommunication. The Lux Bard combination where everybody's caught, but Mithy just kind of
saves the
bad
day
timing.
For the other team, good. I do like the Magias from Waylitz though. Upgraded that Dark Seal that he got early, so he does know that kind of the big carry his team needs. He's got the big scoreline, so certainly in all the right places there. So that redemption is done for Mithy as well. Mad Life still working on the Aegis, kind of realizes that, alright. The big fat AP carries, maybe the one I want to mitigate some damage from.
And this is a 1-8 Illaoi, a champion that technically should be useless when falling behind. Smeb hasn't really been able to like destroy him for quite a while, and that's suddenly he's trying again.
He's trying very hard.
He has just poked him down so slowly because the all-in is still tricky. There's some armor penetration for Ziv, there is sustain as well, and of course the big ulti. It's a very slow fight.
No one else is coming. I did check the mini map briefly to see if there was any excitement, but
still no one.
There's none.
Still no one. We can use this time to pump out some stats, maybe. I just got told that Waylitz is currently at 41% of the team's damage, which is,
oh, wow.
is not surprising. He's getting there. He could be number one soon, Deficio.
Who's all the way? Oh, the rest of people coming. Yes, double lift. Surprise.
That's cheating.
That is cheating.
Come on, it was a 1v1. Smeb is actually. Well, so now Team Fire's going Baron? Alright.
See, it's Smeb. He's got the brain.
That's it. He's making the call. That's it. Now Double is sitting bottom.
Oh,
quick push.
No, baby! Feels bad. Gets himself over the wall, but
it's fine.
By the poke down. No! There's another level in there, but he actually jukes around it. Windslash didn't quite go where he wanted it to, but there is the snipe. Optimus manages to take him down.
Baby just wanted to buy more time for his team. He got hooked in on purpose. Had to run away. Ended up dying, sadly. Double is still bottom lane, split pushing.
Of
While
course.
His team is about to do Baron, this is technically Season 2 all over again.
And look,
it is.
We've got a brush cam going on. That's a wonderful League of Legends. Oh, that hook's going to miss. Everything's going to miss, actually.
I mean, nobody is going
so
to...
So is that. Damn.
Nobody's stopping Double Lift. That's all.
Optimus!
There we go!
Yeah, classic!
I mean, Jakos is dead, but he did get Optimus.
What?
Ooh, hello. Good really? Fight, maybe not quite. Waylitz off court, that's not what you want, but a good stunt from Mithias. Smeb tries to chase him down with the train. Double Lift has now taken the inhibitor. I feel like that's a bad thing.
I feel like it is.
I mean, no one was stopping him. It didn't seem like a bad thing. Maybe they knew something I didn't. Turns out, no. At least I also know that losing that inhibitor is bad.
It is 4-5 in the bottom lane for Zip, though. Waylitz might go down.
Oh, Waylitz. It's okay. It's not okay. He gets grabbed by Madlife. And another shutdown. Two kills now for Madlife. You go, Madlife.
Back down to second. As Levy, this time, now they're going to try and head for that Baron. Everybody's half health, but nobody's really got anything here, so.
Kind of a good game without Baron. It's not a fun time.
Ziv is going to try 1v5.
They're even going to let them come in. Ziv pulls one out. Double lift in the back. That's not a good look at all. Levy, he's trying to finish the Baron. He does do so, but now they're going to turn out the Baby who gets blown to pieces. He just disappeared, and now Double Lift's going to chase another down. Mithy pops up the flare. Dangerous proposition. Good flash out from under the stun. Portal's out of the way, but Levy's going to chase him down. The rest of the team flies in as well. Double Lift not stunned, and there's the cleanup.
Everything going wrong for Team Ice now. Fire it all starts with that kill in the bottom lane. Double Lift coming down. kills Zev, then they TP up to Baron, they get a few more kills, bait around the Baron, double thing in here. Team Fire, they have everything right now.
I don't know why the NALCS squad didn't play this kind of strat. Just let double F go, you know, do everything
it's
else.
It's clearly working.
I know.
In a highly competitive game.
Hang on, I don't know. I don't know if that's ever worked in NA before. I might not be familiar with the strategy.
I mean, it works.
Mad Life ruining that Illaoi one before as well by just chain CCing Ziv.
Terrible performance, but, you know, it's all really on the anticipation of the next time Jankos has his ultimate game.
Which is now.
Yeah.
Basically waiting for Optimus to die.
Optimus comes into vision.
I mean, Optimus could do himself a favor and just buy an Hourglass, and as soon as he sees Nocturne's ult, he just click it. Oh, Cycles.
Oh, that cannon minion.
Yeah.
He's been deterred. He's back. Okay, from Optimus isn't bad. Ooh, not enough for a snipe. I'm gonna try and wait for that to wear off, but Smeb's gonna dive in instead. Baby's a target, he's not gonna hit him. But now Wayla's thrown out completely, and Levy's just gonna dive in there. Tower's gonna fall, Smeb.
But that's an
He's put an Hourglass. I like it, Madlife finds Wayla's there as well, hooks him in, and that's gonna be another kill. Team Fire, they may not have won the 2016 tournament, they're gonna try and push him for this game.
He's got Levy,
he's getting shot down by Double Imp Killers there. Now gonna dance in around Zip, can Double Imp clean up the rest of the kills? Madlife again, huge hook there. Smeb diving into the Fountain, that's a quadra kill for Double Imp. And Team Fire, I don't think they can wait for the Penta, but knock down the turrets and take the Nexus and win this exhibition game. What a wonderful performance.
Yeah, definitely a game won by superior macro from Team Fire in this game. After they got that kill in the ball, they went Baron.
Really
closed out the game. Madlife can be happy. 2-1 15 on the Blitzcrank. Didn't get to see the Madlife, I actually promised.
No.
Me, I'm sorry.
No. Didn't get it. Double lift. As soon as he locked in Vayne, we knew this was one game.
Yes.
That's always how it goes.
Yes. And as soon as Levy locked in Riven, we were
It was the whole game. Whole game was done.
The key picks.
I was a little sad to not see this map Riven, but it turns out the Sion just as good. Isn't over the tank picks here and there, but a very fun one. And the Hourglass was perfect for initiation towards the end. Right?
I mean, yeah.
Does that work?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Gives you armor, you know, there's plenty of good stuff in there.
I mean, Jankos is never going to kill him. He's an assassin, he's not going to get assassinated, that's perfect.
Very disappointed Jankos didn't go for Optimus in that last round. And they actually went for Levy to kill him.
Could a real kill.
I think they could have won if they had done.
Yeah, kind of misunderstood the plan there. It was a very clear game plan from Team Ice. Kill Optimus from basically minute two, where Mithy roamed in, then Jankos was there, then Mithy was there again, and yeah, they kept trying. Everyone else from Team Fire was just kind of running crazier across the map, though, especially on top side.
I liked the play where, you know, there was 2 minutes of tank fighting on the bottom lane, then double lift roams down.
That was the macro play.
That was it. That's revolutionary here. You've heard of rotations. That right there is the pinnacle. We're going to see that
AD
every
carry
game.
Rotation.
Every game in LCK next split, okay?
You've broken the meta game? Amazing.
Everything.
I mean, all jokes aside, like, whoever's calling shots there, I'm not saying there were only Kreons on one team. They had slightly better macro in the fun game. But there were only Kreons on one team, and look what happened.
Well, we did have Wayless on Team Ice, trying his very hardest to carry this game and claim that number one LPL
only
performer spot.
Only he was the best officio.
If only he had been the number one. But sadly,
officio, next year your list may have to change, but we are going to send it to the analyst desk for a closer look at that one.
Thank you so much, ice pastry. That would be delicious right about
That's
now.
That's actually on the prompt.
An ice pastry.
I saw that, the ice pastry.
We invite you, and then you started admitting that everything that we say that's funny
scripted.
I gotta
tell the fans what's scripted.
Oh my God. Okay, very fun game to watch. Ziv was quite funny to me because he wanted to trigger Smeb PTSD from playing versus your Illaoi yesterday. Yeah, what did you think of it?
I think he played fine, but the issue against Sion, I guess, is that the stun is really long and Illaoi doesn't work too well against a lot of stuns, so yeah, Riven got a lot of kills on top lane, and yeah, Wayless tried his best to carry Mithy and Jankos, but...
I don't know this strategy, though, because this is a bit of training wheels for Smeb. He's now played at least 2 games against an Illaoi, so Korea 2017 champions.
Korea, okay. Some interesting things walk down memory lane. Of course, Madlife, Blitzcrank. Oh. Fantastic. It's been a while since we've seen it.
No 2016 games at all. You know, usually you get that one game, but his team, unfortunately, has been struggling. So no, like, kind of victory lap Blitzcrank games. Last game, as far as I remember, was maybe All-Stars last year.
You looked it up on your phone a second
ago. I did, actually. That's also... It's not on the prompter, so it's not scripted necessarily, but it was the final of the regional finals against the EULCS.
It was. Let's see what it looks like to be Mad Hooked on Life, powered by Acer. He still has it, Mad Life, but we never really doubted that.
Yeah, and the Bard, you think about Bard, who we've seen a lot of in 2016. Great answer to be able to just hook through the magical journey. You know, it's almost the timing is there, and Mad Life was definitely back.
And we have another Blitzcrank legend here, by
That's
the
true.
Way. Soaz, who played it once in a serious tiebreaker game in the EULCS.
I think I played it twice.
Twice?
No? Yeah, one fun time with to get a lot of kills to Reckless, and more seriously.
And when you were like kind of training, wasn't it Mad Life who took inspiration from? This is the guy you look at, you have to say, for hook accuracy.
Not so much for Blitzcrank, I guess.
Wasn't it?
I don't know.
Wasn't it
Fresh, then, I guess?
I think... Besides 2 years ago, Blitzcrank was my most played in solo queue. my three first years, but yeah.
Sorry for interrupting, I was just trying to remember. Wasn't it, there's one important match that you guys did it too for like Worlds qualification or playoff seeding or something important back in season three?
I can't remember. I think it was only for KD of Reckless one time. and the other time it was against...
versus Frog?
EG, maybe?
Yeah. Whoa, we're getting
turning
old.
Turning back the clock right here. Turning way back.
Yeah, definitely. Some other cool interactions in that game. And that skin from Sion is amazing. And whenever Mithy sometimes, he bar dalted and then Smeb would take the magical journey.
He will try to.
That was so funny. Yeah, good stuff.
I mean, it's exactly what you wanted, right? Because of the 1v1, the tournament was decided. So you had a feeling we were going to see a bit more fun. You know, BB, the season two Ezreal God, back on that champion. Wayless, super tryharding on the Lux. Not necessarily a pick he's known for, but a pick he certainly put to good use. So it was a fun exhibition game, like Pastry Time said, and we still got two more.
Definitely was. And one final thing before we go. Levi throughout the whole tournament, the GPL. He has done some really good things. His Lee Sin was amazing. People are even always so tryhard, but whatever. He's having fun, and it seems to be going easy for him, so that's really nice. Is he a player that's impressed you?
Well, Levi is pretty good, honestly. I don't know so much about his revenge. He was okay, I guess. He was not like super fantastic, but he got a lot of kills going on into early game. But yeah, he's pretty good overall. So.
And look, he's from a region that people don't know a lot about, like the GPL, especially after the LMS broke away. And we already had multiple players here talking about, okay, I'm starting to look for, you know, the future, looking for future teams. You got people like even Bengi saying, I'm looking for an audition. So it's kind of one of the interesting scenarios where you're like,
he is a jungler. So
that's true. All I mean is like, this is an audition for even someone like Levi when it comes to potentially going overseas in the future.
Yeah, fantastic point. Great game, great tournament for him. We are going to take a quick break, but next we melt ice and fire together again for another mixed region matchup. And later we'll be celebrating League of Legends 2016 with a closing ceremony you absolutely won't want to miss. Don't touch that browser.